Now, It could have been us on the other side of that gun. But he kept us here because he wanted us to continue to bless his name. So if you came to bless his name, let me just put your hand in the air with us today. Come on.
Yeah.
truly blessed to be in the house of God today. Quick testimony before I move on. See, every year I go through something where my body does something where I cannot go to sleep. I don't know if it's a pinched nerve. I don't know what it is. But this happens to me every year. But as I was home, I was walking around, trying to go to sleep because this thing does something to my body. But I was just walking around my house, just trying to get myself together. Lord, help me, help me, help me. But when I was thinking, I was like, if I just make it to the morning, if I just can make it to the morning, that's why when I hear that part right here, that's why I say, listen, say, lady in the midnight hour, God's gonna turn it around. It's gonna work in your favor. I told y'all last week, this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in. How many of you are rejoiced for this morning? Holiday weekend. You got another day off if you work on Mondays. If that's not enough to thank God for right there. How many know that God is the true living word?
Down from glory,
many things
you
and we're going to put them all together, and we're going to cry this. Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
That's what we call you.
That's what we call you.
Angel born.
Angel born, but on the tree, you died to save humanity. You are the living word.
Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
That's what we call. Hallelujah to your name, God. It's time to worship of him in this place. We're just going to say one other thing to you right now. How many of you came to love on God this morning? If you truly came to love on God this morning, if you just could just extend your arms and just start to worship God in this place where you are. Right there. Said, I love you, God.
I love you.
be a victim, God. We love you, God, but not taking our life, God. We are grateful just to be here today, Jesus. We honor you for allowing us to just be here today. You care for us in such a special way.
Praise God, saints. Praise the Lord. Picky, haha. Can I get a handkerchief, please? We thank God for you on today. Thank you, Reverend Chisholm, Pastor Chisholm. Thank you, praise team. Thank you, ushers. I never thanked the ushers. Yeah, thank you, ushers. In this holiday weekend. Amen. If you will, raise your Bibles. I didn't bring a Bible up here. That's okay. I got this. I got the scripture right here. This is the word of God. This word is eternal. This word is quick, powerful, and sharp. This word is relevant, truth, and spirit. This word will change my life. I believe it. My faith comes through it. I am what it says I am. And I'll do what it says for me to do. This word is alive. It is. And look at somebody and say, and you are the living word. Shout glory. Honey, would you come pray Dr. Stephanie, Reverend Doctor? And Andrew or Miko, can you bring me a chair, please? That thing swivels. I need a chair. Yeah, oh, Lord. What? Mama.
Thank you, Lord.
Go ahead, Dr. Stephanie.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Father, we come before you this morning as humble as we know how, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We posture our hearts in your presence right now, God. We thank you, Father, that your glory fills this temple today.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, we lift up your holy name and in every single fashion, Father, in worship, in prayer, and in the spoken and written word, Father, in praise. We honor you, Father, because of who you are in our lives, God. We know you as being Alpha and Omega and everything in between, God. Father, we know that there's not one need that we have, the Father, that you don't already know about and has already made petitions.
Yes, God.
To fulfill. Father, I thank you right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, for the manifestation of your word that's about to come forth, God. Father, give us ears to hear.
Hallelujah.
And a heart to receive what thus said the Lord, Father. Too many people are walking around with itching ears, Father, waiting to hear something that's going to tickle their fancy. But Father, what we need right now is a dunamis word from you, Father, full of power, so that we can go forth, oh Lord, out into this world and do all the things that you have called us to do, Father, big or small. So, Father, we thank you on today. We thank you for Pastor Beard, Father. We thank you for the impartation of truth that you've already bestowed upon him, Father. Father, I pray right now in the name of Jesus, Father, as he sits in his stool, Father, that he sits in your presence, Father, that he yields his heart towards heaven right now, Father, and only say what you say to say, Father. Quicken him, Father, in his space, the space where he is right now, Lord. Fill him with your spirit, Lord. There's no room and no time right now for any of us to be up here saying anything that you have not told us to say, Father.
Amen.
So, Father, I just thank you right now, Lord, that he is under your care, under your watch, under your spirit, filled with your spirit, Father. So may your word go forth with power, and may we walk away with today filled with you, more of you, Lord, so that we can be all that you've called us to be. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Stephanie. Our scripture for our topic for today is, this game is not over yet. Now, y'all know I'm country. I'd rather say it like I say it. This ain't over yet. Oh, my God. 21. In Texas. How many? 20 in, was it 20 in New York? 19? Just dead. Hatred throughout the land. Complete and total disdain for valuable human beings. Complete disdain. Hate. Because of the color of your skin. Hatred. I'll get to that later. Happy Memorial Day, by the way. And we want to remember all of those who served and gave their lives for this country. But I'll add to that all the people that are dying right now. It's heartbreaking. It's heartbreaking. And believe it or not, it could happen to you. But let me tell you something. This game ain't over with yet. Run on just a little while longer and see what the end will be. If you would, join me in reading Isaiah 11, verse 9, wherein it reads, I'd ask you today to look at the monitor, and if you want to repeat it with me, we want to release the word of God into the atmosphere together, unified. Reading from the same book, the same version, it says the same thing. It says, the cut-off stump of Jesse will sprout, and a faithful branch will grow from his roots. The spirit of Yahweh will rest upon him, and the spirit of extraordinary wisdom, the spirit of perfect understanding, the spirit of wise strategy, the spirit of mighty power, the spirit of revelation, and the spirit of the fear of Yahweh. He will find his delight in the living by the spirit of fear of the Lord. He will neither judge by appearances or make his decisions based on rumors. With righteousness, he will uphold justice for the poor and defend the lowly of the earth. His words will be like a scepter of power that conquers the world, and with his death, he will slay the lawless one. Righteousness will be his warrior sash and faithfulness his belt. Then the wolf will be subdued and live with the gentle lamb, and the leopard will lie down with the gentle lamb. The young calf and the ferocious lion will be together, And as a shepherd drives his flock, a small child will guide them. The cow and the bear will graze alongside each other. Cubs and calves will lie down together. The lion, like the ox, will eat straw. The nursing child will play safely near the rattlesnake's den, and the toddlers will stretch out his hand and shine light over the serpent. On all my holy mountain of Zion, nothing evil or harmful will be found, for the earth will be filled with the intimate knowledge of the Lord Yahweh, just as water swells the sea. May God give us teachable minds and understanding hearts as we believe, accept, and walk out his holy word. Amen? Amen. This game ain't over. You know, I read a book years ago. I think it was James Dobson. I think it was entitled, Where is God When You Need Him? Now, you know, a lot of people are asking that question that have been affected by COVID. Lord, where are you when we need you? And all these shootings, 482 mass shootings, well, multiple killings in the last couple of years. Do you know what that is? Do you know how many families that affects? Wives, children? It affects so many. Now, let me give you a short analogy. There are all kind of games to play besides board games. When I was growing up, we played a lot of board games. And I don't know about y'all, but I don't play games no more because I don't like to lose. I don't play nothing. No dominoes, no cards. But there are all kind of games that people play, just as in sports. There's all kind of subheadings under sports. Football, baseball, basketball, tennis. What else? Hockey, soccer, wrestling. I see little C. Cool over there, wrestling champion. All kind of games, of a multiplicity of games being played. Now, but there are many more being played that you don't see on TV. In humanity, social media, cyber world, morality, TV, and particularly, don't get mad, the church. The church is playing games. The church is playing games. See? And the games we see are being played on us right in front of us. Let that marinate. It's no secret. You know? All being played right in front of us. And you know what? You play on the team too, whether you like it or not, or whether you know it or not, you're a team participant. One way or another. One way or another, we all participate, whether we want to play or not. Now, the game I'm talking about is called, it's deadly, it's a deadly game. You die from it, for sure. You die from it when you play it the devil's way. It's called spiritual and mental assault and satanic harassment. You want to know what's wrong with these Republicans? I just told you. You want to know what's wrong with 71 million people in this country? I just told you. They're playing a deadly game. Texas, New York, Ukraine, mass shootings, all the last tragedies. The devil may think he's winning. Now see, these teams are owned, operated, and created by the devil. Yeah, it ain't but one owner. You know, like you have somebody own a team, the devil owns this team. And I want to tell you, the game, oh, it's being played, and we all have to participate in it some way or another. But it's being played. And you know what? The church is the one getting played. When we go along with everything, when we don't have an opinion, when we aren't activated, when we don't pray, when we don't support our local ministries, when we forsake the fellowship of the saints. Oh, you playing the game. When we go out and willfully sin, you playing the game. When you open your mouth against somebody, you playing the game. When you don't give the way you should, you playing the game. When you don't participate, don't worship, don't want to work, you playing the game. But let me tell you this, you the one getting played all day long. All day long. The game's not over. The team may be getting off to a good start. And it may look like they're going to win. When I used to watch sports with Dr. Stephanie back when she was watching them, I saw many times where a team was winning like crazy and another team came out from behind and won the game. Now, I don't watch basketball, but I seen on the news, you know, where the end of the game, and somebody make a shot from half court, I don't know, way out there. And the minute that shot hits, the buzzer goes off and the other team wins. See, it ain't over until it's over. And let me tell you something. We got a referee. Do you know him? Do you obey him? Do you play the game the way, his game, the way it's designed to be played? It's something wrong out there, y'all. It's something so wrong out there. Now, back in the Old Testament, there's this little bitty nation. Speaking of prophets, there was one by the name of Isaiah. And his task was to offer the people of Judah some words of encouragement and comfort amid the political, international turmoil all around them. That sound familiar? We need some comfort. I got so sick of watching MSNBC all the time. Dr. Stephanie will tell you, I got a cowboy flick on all day long while I'm on my computer. And then at night, Gunsmoke. And I'm telling y'all, y'all need to watch Gunsmoke. You want to really know something about life. I'll flip the Gunsmoke quicker than a rat to run across the roof and with a piece of liver in his mouth. Festa says that. You know, and it just makes me happier than a ring-tail badger. Okay. Now, Judah had a reason to be afraid. Two nations was coming against it. And these were international situations like today. Finance, hate, race, just like it is today. And the word came to two of Judah's enemies, that two of Judah's enemies, Syria and the Israelites, had formed an alliance to come against them, and it looked bad for Judah. It looked bad, bad, bad. But you know what it was? Aha! It was a way to make sure the game wouldn't end the way those guys wanted. Judah. They didn't know it then. But the game wasn't over because they had a star player coming on the scene. A trophy winner. The biggest, most known trophy to humanity. The cross of Jesus Christ. Now you're talking about a star. He didn't act like a star, but he came with a star on that first advent. Yeah, they were afraid they couldn't defend themselves against such evil. They were afraid that they would be overrun and overtaken. But the game wasn't over. Not that game. Well, then, who is this star player? Who is this surprise entry? You know, a few weeks ago, you know, and that's what you have to understand about being a star. You don't have to be at the front to be a star. At the Kentucky Derby a couple weeks ago, there was this horse that wasn't even supposed to be in it. The last pick of the bunch. Sound familiar like Jesus? The last one anybody would bet on. And he came from the rear, and he won that race with 80 to 1 odds. Sounds like Jesus' odds. Sounds like some of your odds. When I came to Nashville, I didn't know one human being, not one single one. Not one single one. Not one. Not one. I didn't know nobody. But here we are 32 years later. You don't have to be a star. You don't have to be first to be a star. See? And as that child grew up, it said, Isaiah says, before he even knows the difference between right and wrong, the land before whose two kings you are in, you are in dread, will be deserted. He prophesied. They will be defeated. Oh, you know, your enemy's gonna be defeated. No weapon formed against you can prosper. It doesn't mean that a weapon ain't gonna be formed against you. Oh, because it will. But that game ain't over. I'm sending a star player. I'm sending a star player, and he's going to defeat you. Even then, the game is not over. At that time, in that time of apparent victory, the game wasn't over. You know, like, you can get beat down, but you can sure get up again. Am I right about that? See, I mean, the defeat is not being knocked down. The victory is when you get back up. And you trust God and know that I don't care what the enemy throws at you, that game ain't over yet. See, everybody know that. The devil even know. He knows how it's going to turn out. He knows what his end is going to be. He knows that Jesus is coming back. He knows. I want to ask you, do you know that your Lord is coming back? Oh, yeah. The devil even knows. all these agnostic and atheist and questioning God folk out there, they know better. Because the devil know better. Y'all hear me? No such thing. No such thing. This wonderful one is going to enter the game. He says, unto us a child is born. To us a son is given. And the government will be upon his shoulders. And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father. That's a promise. It's not just a saying. That's a promise. And still more, he said, more extraordinary things. He went on to say that the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding and all of those things, counsel, knowledge, and the fear of the Lord will rest upon him. And at last, he talks about the wolf laying down with the lamb. Now, who ever heard of such a thing like that? He said, the leopard will lie down with the kid. Are y'all feeling him on this? In other words, he said, this game ain't over with. At some point, everything is going to change. How many of y'all believe that? Now, that's a wonderful vision. But we got to believe it, accept it, and pray about it, and in faith, believe God for it. The game ain't over. I mean, I don't care how bleak it looks. I don't care how many points the enemy scores. It ain't over. It's not over. But this vision of the whole world being at peace, That's God. That ain't right. If he say the world gonna be at peace at some point, then what? The world gonna be at peace at some point. Hatred and animosity, white supremacy, all that. It's going on down the road somewhere. Natural enemies will begin to get along with each other. And we're going to live in a world of universal peace. That's hard to believe, isn't it? Not when you believe the Lord. Not when you believe this right here. A land completely free from hate, bondage, fear. That'll be a time when your kids... Excuse me, I need to blow my nose, but my wife said don't do it in public in the pulpit. Freedom. A land where black, brown, yellow, red, and white can live together, can love together, can share together. When righteousness is everywhere. Everywhere. That sounds good, doesn't it? We can wish for that right now, can't we? We can believe for it right now, can't we? I'm going somewhere with that. Can you imagine that vision, though, child of God? Can't you just see it? And it's not euphoria. Can you even imagine what he said? They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy nation. No suffering. No hurt. Now, of course, we know this vision is not come true at this point right now. See? Whether you understand that to be about Isaiah's day or you believe like I do, the word of God is eternal. The word of God doesn't change. it's always the same. So if it was true then, you tell me, is it true now? Oh, yeah. See, he's not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man who would have to repent. The Messiah has come, Jesus Christ. And let me tell you this, and he will come again sooner than you think. So I ask you, is your house in order? Are you ready for Jesus? Are you ready for the star player to step in the game? Are you ready for some peace? Are you ready when he comes? He's the appointed one. Peace seems so far from us, child of God. But let me tell you, it's coming. One day you're going to lift up your bow down here and know that Jesus is Lord. And there will be peace on earth. And hatred will be taken away, totally discarded. But wait, let me get back to my major thing. It ain't over. It ain't over yet. Don't be in despair. Keep looking toward the hill. See, look toward the hills for the advent of Christ, because he's coming back for you. How many of y'all believe that? Yeah, he's coming back for you, and everything will be subject to change. The enemy won't have an advantage no more. And so when I see Jesus, when we share his birth again, for his coming, we can see the kingdom coming with him. How many of y'all believe that? Oh, yeah. He's bringing his kingdom with him. He's the root, the shoot from the stump of Jesse. Y'all know what that means? Huh? What was David's daddy's name? Huh? And Jesus is the root of David. He is everything David never could have been. It all began there, and it all ended on the Christ, on the cross. So like Jesus told, or the angel told him, be not afraid. Don't be scared. God is in control. Whether you know it or not, or whether you believe it or not, God is in control. He knows what's going on. He knows what's happening with you right now. Don't be afraid of Caesar and Herod or Putin or Kim Jong-un or all these people. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. This game is far from being over. And even if you don't see it in your lifetime, the star player is going to enter this game. And we are going to come from behind against all odds and be the winners in the end. How many of y'all believe that? Pray for those poor people who are just losing loved ones left and right. Pray for them. I do it all day. I don't ever stop. Whatever I see, I pray about. Constantly. I don't pray once a day and let that be that. I pray for peace and God's compassion and God's love to envelop. They hadn't even buried all the people in Buffalo yet. And these cats running around here talking about mental illness. That ain't mental illness, that's pure evil. And pure evil is filling this world. But that's why you're here. You can make the difference. You can make the difference. And let me remind you that the star player gonna be on the field before you know it. I gotta watch. I like that. My wife bought it for me. He's gonna be on the field sooner than you think. And one day the game is gonna end. And regardless what happens in the earth realm, one day we're gonna all give an account. One day all of us is going to stand in before the great white throne. And we're gonna give an account. Oh no, you will. And all these people running around here, that 71 million and even more, are gonna be the main ones talking about, Lord, Lord, didn't I? He gonna say, what? Who are you? I never knew you. Now get out of my face. You don't want that to be you. But your work is gonna be evaluated. Your work is going to be evaluated. So come to God right now. Reverend Stephanie, Doctor. I'm good.
Thank you, Lord.
Both nasal.
Thank you, Father, for your word. Your word tells us that it will not return to you void. It will accomplish everything that you sent it to do today, Father. So for that, we thank you, Father. Father, as we sit in this place today, Lord, basking in the word that has just gone forth, Lord. Father, I ask you right now that you show us our hearts, Lord, where we are in the game. Father, we showing up the way that you've called us to show up, Father. Are we in it to be seen, or are we in it to evangelize and to be the light so that others can know who you are, Father, and what must they do to be saved, Father? Help us to see ourselves, oh God, in this space where we are right now, how we're showing up at work, how we're showing up in our families, how we're showing up in the church. How are we showing up, Father? Help us to identify that place, Lord. Because I know, Lord, that whatever you reveal, Father, you are prepared to correct and heal. Father, it is time for us to be watchmen on the wall. These incidents are happening, Father, because there's not enough of us praying, faithing, and believing, Father. It's not enough of us ministering to the lost, Father. Our hearts go out to those families, those precious babies. Every time I close my eyes and think about their precious little faces, Father, my heart grieves. Grieves. Their children at school and their teachers trying to save their lives, Father. And even the one teacher whose husband grieved so deeply that he had a heart attack and died himself. Go with that little town, Father, predominantly Hispanic, Latino town, Father. Let your spirit hover over that town right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Father, whatever healing agent that you send along the way, I know the president is going today, Father, may his words be laced with your words, Lord, to give those people comfort right now. People are coming from the north, the south, the east, and the west to stand in unity with these people, Father, in solidarity, Father. And I'm asking you in the name of Jesus, let your light be present, Father, because it's so much hurt and so much pain. It's only going to take you, Father, to begin to make any sense out of what has happened to those precious babies, Father. And Father, let us not sit on the sideline of what's happened. If there's anything that we can do as the church, Father, besides pray, how can we help, Father? How can we sow seed into helping to bury these children, these families, help these families out, Father? Let us not be bystanders. but be participant in your work, Father. That's what you call us to do in this space where we are right now. Even for those families in Buffalo and the families to come, Father. We thank you, though, Lord, because we're here today. And we praise you, God. We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord, because we're still breathing and we're still here, Father. And the word says, let everyone that has breath praise the Lord. So, God, we thank you today. And we pause in your presence right now, Lord. And, Father, I just thank you for the word that came forth. Because Jesus Christ will return, Father. He will return just as you said that he would, Father, with all power in his hands, Father. And, Father, as long as we yield ourselves to you and to Christ, Father, we'll be found in your will, Lord. So just help us on today. Help us to walk out of here today and to be better representations of you, Father, witnessing to everyone that we know and living with purpose, Father. And, Father, it's in the mighty and the matchless name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen and amen.
Before Pastor Chisholm comes, I have a personal request. I talked to Anvil. I talked to Felicia. And so I want please help. I really need somebody who is willing to undertake it and to bring about whatever it takes. You know, me and Dr. Stephanie are going to contribute. And I'm sure many of you others, Alan said he would. And so I'm going to look forward to seeing what you pledge and what you give. Seeing that parking lot with no holes, all black. Nice white stripes and that drain, but when it rains, water runs off, okay? Praise God. June 4th, man. Men say, thank God I'm a man. Well, I thank God I'm a man. Woo. Lord have mercy.
Praise God, praise God. Come on, y'all, give God a praise in this place. See this?